Hello children, in this video we will discuss the summary of the story On a Beam of Light, which is written by Jennifer Budney. She is an American writer who has written several books for children and has contributed to various magazines. This story is about the childhood of the great scientist Albert Einstein. Einstein worked on many important theories of science. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1921. Let's start our story. Over 100 years ago, as the stars swirled in the sky, as the earth circled the sun, as the March winds blew through little town by a river, a baby boy was born. His parents named him Albert. Albert turned 1 year old and didn't say a word. Albert turned 2 and did not say a word. Albert turned 3 and hardly said a word at all. He just looked around with his big curious eyes. Look and wonder. His parents worried. Little Albert was so different. Was there something wrong? But he was their baby, so they loved him no matter what. One day, when Albert was sick in bed, his father brought him a compass, a small round case with a magnetic needle inside. No matter which way Albert turned the compass, the needle always pointed north. As if held by an invisible hand, Albert was so amazed, his body trembled. Suddenly, he knew there were mysterious in the world, hidden and silent, unknown and unseen. He wanted more than anything to understand those mysterious. Albert started asking questions. Questions at home, questions at school. So many questions that some of his teachers told him he was a distraction to his class. They said he would never amount to anyone, anything, unless he learned to behave like the other students. But Albert did not want to be like the other students. He wanted to discover the hidden mysteries in the world. One day, as Albert was zipping through the countryside on his bicycle, he looked up at the beams of sunlight speeding from the sun to the earth. He wondered what would it be like to ride one of those beams, and in his mind, right then and there, Albert was no longer on his bicycle, no longer on the country road. He was racing through space on a beam of light. It was biggest, most exciting thought Albert had ever had, and it filled his mind with questions. Albert began to read and study. He read about light and sound, about heat and magnetism, and about gravity, the invisible force that pulls us down towards our planet and keeps the moon from floating away into the outer space. When Albert graduated from college, he wanted to teach the subjects he loved. All the things he had read about all those years. But Albert could not find a job as a teacher. So, he got another job. A simple, quiet job in a government office. An office where he worked with other people's ideas and inventions. He did his work very well and very quickly. So quickly that he had lots of extra time to think and wonder. Albert wrote down his new ideas, put them into an envelope, and sent them to science magazines. The magazines printed everything Albert sent. He hoped that scientists and professors would be interested, and they were very interested indeed. They asked Albert to come work with them and teach with them. For the first time in his life, people started to say, "Albert is a genius." Now Albert could spend all his days doing what he loved: imagining, wondering, figuring. Albert thought about very, very big things like the size and shape of the entire universe. He thought about very, very small things like what goes inside the atoms that everything is made of. He discovered whole new ways to understand how are these things work. Sometimes when Albert was having a tough time with the tricky problem, he would put it aside and play his violin. Music made Albert happy. He said it made him think better. Everywhere Albert went, he tried to figure out the secrets of the universe, and he never forgot about the beam of light that he rode so long along in his imagination. Albert figured out that no person, no thing could ever zoom through space as fast as a beam of light. Albert thought and figured until the very last minute of the very last day of his life. He asked questions never asked before, found answers never found before, and dreamed up ideas never dreamed before. Albert's ideas left to build spaceships and satellites that traveled to the moon and beyond. His thinking helped us understand our universe as no one had ever before. But still, Albert left us many big questions. Questions that scientists working on today. Questions that someday you may answer by wondering, thinking, and imagining. Okay, children? This is the story of famous scientist Albert Einstein. In the next session, we will meet new lesson with interesting videos. I hope all you are understood. Thank you.